Hey guys, welcome to my channel. Today I'm going to show you how I bake my lemon crinkle cookies. So let's quickly take a look at all the ingredients that we're going to need. Starting off with a large mixing bowl, 150 grams of room temperature butter, 100 grams of granulated sugar, and then we will need 15 ml of freshly squeezed lemon juice, an egg, and finally our 150 grams of all-purpose flour. But it doesn't end here, guys, because to this flour we're going to add a few more ingredients. We're going to start with adding a quarter teaspoon of baking powder and the same quarter teaspoon of salt. And finally, a quarter teaspoon of turmeric. The turmeric powder is optional, is just to make sure that the vibrant yellow color really pops in your cookies without hampering the taste. Now that we have all our main ingredients, let's start by preparing the cookie dough. First, we take our soft room temperature butter in our mixing bowl, to which we're going to add our granulated sugar. So now we need to mix these two till we get a light and airy butter mixture. It's gonna slowly turn into a light yellow color as well. As you can see, I had tried using a spatula to mix these two, but that was not working out. Also, I had made the rookie mistake of not putting a kitchen towel at the bottom of my bowl. Now that I've placed it, you can see I have more stability and it's easier to mix. This is why it's important to use soft room temperature butter, because if I had used cold butter, bringing these two together would be a nightmare on my hands. As you can see, the more I mix, the more the butter and sugar are coming together in a nice, creamy and fluffy manner. This is what we want. We want our butter to become really light. Alright, now that I'm happy with my butter mixture, I'm going to add a teaspoon of lemon zest along with the 15 ml of our freshly squeezed lemon juice. And please don't mix as aggressively as I did, because that's just going to create a mess. So after gently mixing the ingredients, we can crack our egg into the mixture. Please be careful not to drop any shells in it, because it is going to be a hassle to fish it out, and if you are unable to take it out and you miss it, that's just gonna add a surprise crunch which we don't need in our cookies. Alright, our batter is coming together really well, and now we can add a teaspoon of vanilla essence. The vanilla is going to help mask the eggy flavor, which can be unpleasant to smell, and instead add a much more fragrant flavor to it. So the flour mixture that we had prepared earlier, we can add that all in now. I have baked these cookies quite a few times before, and there were times that I used to sift the flour into the mixture, but I've noticed that even without sifting there is no difference in the cookies, so you can just go ahead and directly pour them. As you can see, our batter is now taking on this creamy smooth texture, which is what we want for our cookies, and this is also the consistency that works out perfectly. We have to now take this dough and put it in our fridge to chill for 30 to 40 minutes. If you do have the time, please go ahead and chill it for an hour, because that's always better. For our next step, I'm preparing my baking tray by laying on my parchment paper, and I've also prepared a cup of powdered sugar. It's been a good 40 minutes, so I've taken out my chilled dough. As you can see, that it's quite firm at this point. So I'm going to use a teaspoon to help me with the cookie shaping process. This is roughly the size of all the cookies that we're going to need. It's like a small ping pong ball, I guess. This process can get messy, so if you need, you can wear gloves, but I'm going to use my clean hands. First, I start by flouring my hands with the powdered sugar to prevent sticking. And then I'll scoop out a tiny amount of the dough with the help of my teaspoon. Now I'm going to roll this dough between my palms and create small cookie balls. You don't want them to be too big as they will expand later on. So I find this size to be perfect. I'm going to now drop my cookie into the powdered sugar and make sure to coat it really well. After that, I'm going to place it on my baking tray. Alright then, it just gave it a little kiss. Anyways, so now we just have to repeat this process and continue making our batches. So powdering my hands will actually help me later on in the process, as the more batches you make, the more the dough tends to revert back to its creaminess, which is when you really don't want the dough to stick to your hands. Now there are two ways to bake these cookies. First is to directly bake them right now and put it in your oven, which is fine. But I always go for the second method, which is to chill them for an extra 30 minutes. After 30 minutes, I've taken my cookies out and I'm sprinkling some powdered sugar on them. This too is optional, as I've seen that it makes the cookies too sweet. So depending on your taste, you can skip this step. My family has a sweet tooth, so I went ahead and I sprinkled some. And now comes the fastest and easiest part, which is baking. I'm baking them at 180 degrees Celsius, and I love watching this part where the balls flatten out and take on the traditional cookie shape. It's really nice and it's so quick, just 12 minutes. So the first time that I had baked these cookies, I had made the mistake of taking them out too soon, like this, which is not right. You want to wait till the edges take on the brown color of the caramelized sugar. That's when you know they are done to perfection. These cookies take just 20 minutes to cool down to room temperature. Which is great, because I hate waiting, which is one of the hardest parts to do when you're baking anything. Once baked, please store the cookies in an airtight container. These cookies can be stored for a good week, week and a half. Alright, let me show you how light and airy these cookies are. Just look at that. So that's it guys, this is how you make soft lemon crinkle cookies, and honestly this is the easiest recipe ever. It takes zero skill, which is a big bonus for an amateur like me, and you get like a good 24 cookies from this batter. It's a great accompaniment while having tea or coffee, or if you're like me who just needs a 3 a.m. snack. So I hope you guys like this week's video. Please do share your thoughts in the comment section below. Thank you for watching, and please leave a like, share and subscribe to my channel. It does help a lot. And I'll see you guys next week with a new video. Bye!